we're going to pick one winner to get a free banish kit.
Don't bake your skin, bake banish.
Hi guys, welcome back to another video. I've got my vanilla espresso to get me through the rest of the day. And today I'm going to bring you an exciting new topic. Maybe it's one you've heard a little bit of buzz about. Pretty much everybody and their mom knows that acne causes bacteria, at least in some cases, right? But what if I were to tell you that you could potentially cure your acne by using bacteria? I'm listening. This idea may seem a little far-fetched, it may seem a little out there, maybe it even seems a little bit counterproductive to you to be putting more bacteria on skin that's already got acne. But I hope that if you stick with me through to the end of the video, you'll agree with me that it's pretty promising, it's pretty exciting. And don't forget that at the end of the video, I'm gonna be asking you a question. I want you to leave me an answer in the comments section below, because we're going to pick one winner to get a free banish kit, which contains a banisher, either the stamp or the roller. It contains a wicked nice vitamin C serum that's fantastic either with the roller or just on its own. What are probiotics? Probiotics are a variety of different microorganisms that are considered to be pro-healthful, pro-living. It comes from the term probiotic. These living organisms, they're pro that. These can consist of fungi, bacteria, protists, archaea, and viruses as well. You might already be familiar with the concept of probiotics in our food. We eat probiotics in things like sauerkraut, in cultured yogurts, and you might be familiar with the little probiotic supplements you can get at pretty much any store. Maybe you weren't familiar with the fact that they also have probiotic skincare products, so actual products that you put on your skin with live bacteria. You're probably thinking, whoa, back up, because I cleanse my face twice a day to get rid of bacteria. I use a benzoyl peroxide product, which nicely kills all the bacteria because I have acne and bacteria is bad for acne and I don't want bacteria on my face, so why would I put bacteria on my face? So you've identified the problem right there. Experts have identified that we've lost the balance of good and bad microorganisms on our skin due to our hygienic habits, environmental issues like the sun damage, all of these things, everything we interact with on a daily basis, it affects the organisms living on us. We are like 90% not us. We have so much weight in us that is other microorganisms that we sometimes forget that when they're off balance, that we can be off balance. And so we need to really try and create that balance again. In terms of the good and bad bacteria, the good bacteria would work to protect our skin, to keep our skin's protective barriers up, and it would also work to thwart the efforts of the bad bacteria. Now, the bad bacteria, when the good bacteria are low, the bad bacteria or overexposed to bad bacteria, they can take over and they can take advantage of dry, damaged skin. So the concept behind these products is actually, in my opinion, ingenious. You disturb your skin's microbiome, they call it, so all the organisms that call you home, when we disturb that, we should expect to see skin issues. And so that in order to have healthy skin, and this is no new idea, but in order to have healthy skin, we need to restore balance to the skin. And you've probably seen this concept in, you know, the moisture barrier discussions that we've had, in the sense that you need to restore your skin and repair it so that it's able to do its job. And so this, I feel, is just the little missing piece of the puzzle, that you can give your skin the building blocks of healthy skin, but we rely on bacteria so much. And we really, I don't think, give them enough credit. So I'm really excited about this prospect. The research is still very new. It's very much in its infancy. And there's still a lot of directions this research could go. But maybe I'm being a bit eager, but I think I see at least part of the probiotic movement going in a positive direction. We've learned so much from germ studies thus far, and the potential for them, I think, is just so great. And so What we've learned from these studies has shown us that orally ingested probiotic supplements may or may not help. There's some evidence that it seems to help on a gut level. There's not a lot of strong evidence that it helps with any skin issues. It's been studied not specifically in acne, but in other skin issues, and it just hasn't been conclusive to this point. That doesn't mean that it won't be beneficial or it isn't beneficial. It's that we just don't know enough about it right now to recommend it as a treatment in lieu of other treatments. The flip side is the probiotic skincare movement, and I think that has a lot more gusto behind it in terms of evidence. So I say this because studies have actually shown that when probiotics are applied topically in various different concentrations, different strains, different formulas, so the research isn't all as concrete as we'd like it to be yet, but the studies have shown that topically applied probiotics can actually help the skin maintain moisture better, super important. It can help the skin repel water loss, very important. We can moisturize all we want, but if our skin is losing water, but get this, some studies using topically applied probiotics have actually shown that 50%+ of patients see a reduction in acne lesions. That's huge, like that's super huge. Probiotics, I think, are going to be the next green tea of skincare because they are natural, they are very much rooted in scientific premise, and we've got some evidence already and so early in the research. If you're like me, you're probably thinking, sign me up, like I am on board with this, I want to give it a go because it sounds like it could work. If that's what you're saying, then I'm right there with you. I am in line right behind you. But we should be careful to be a little less eager, I think. I should, at least. That, as I said, the research is still very new, and because there are so many strains on our skin, and we still have only studied just such a small amount of them, what their functions are, we really do need a lot more research at this point, and I think that we're close, and I think we're gonna see a lot of new, exciting research coming out of microbiology and germ studies in the next couple of years, but don't get too excited just yet. I don't think we're quite there yet. Maybe we are. I mean, I am trying a new product for you guys that I'm really excited to review. Maybe it'll change my life. Either way, if you want to try out a probiotic skincare product, you'll probably find that the supply is pretty limited right now. Something that requires a lot more formulations, a lot more product preparation, and so not a lot of skincare companies are offering probiotics just yet. But I think, again, you'll start seeing more coming out, so maybe hold your breath for that. Or, you know, if you want to go the route of the oral probiotics, despite the fact that there's not a ton of hard evidence behind it, there's still the potential, and, you know, it's unlikely that it would cause much harm, so you're probably pretty safe to try that, if that's what you want to do. So, for today's question, let's do a fun one. If you had to pick one ride or die product, or one go-to absolute best product you've ever tried, out of your entire skincare routine or any product you've ever tried, maybe not necessarily still in your routine, let me know in the comments section below. If I had to pick one for myself, I would probably pick the Kiss My Face sunscreen. It's so lame to pick sunscreen, I think, but the sunscreen's been amazing. It's like a second moisturizer to my skin. It, like, my skin just soaks it up. It loves it. It doesn't break it out. I just love it so much. So that would definitely be my ride or die. I couldn't live without it. Put it on every day. And I mean, like, I could use it instead of a moisturizer. That's all I need. So let me know in the comment section below what your favorite product is. I want to know. Thanks. There's a hole.